Hey everyone, this is Richard.
And this is Linda.
Welcome to the Day Zero Gamer Infinite Live Show. This is show number 8 for January 8th, 2012. So how you doing, Linda?
I'm doing great. How are you doing?
Pretty good. So how about this week? What's coming out?
Tuesday, January 10th, My Pet Puppy 3D comes out for the Nintendo 3DS. And that's all I have for this week.
Alrighty then. So let's talk about what we've been playing.
So this past week, I've been playing Modern Warfare 3 multiplayer. I played some Halo Anniversary co-op with you.
Yep.
And I played some more Dead Island co-op. Before, I played with two or three people total, and it was pretty glitchy. I got glitched inside of stairs, like this stairwell or stairway, and you actually had to push me upwards in order to get out of there because I couldn't leave the area. I was stuck inside of the stairs.
Yeah, that I remember
was weird.
That.
Well, that isn't the weirdest thing. When we played with all four people, there were some crazy glitches. I mean, we couldn't turn in quests. We were playing chicken in the trucks. You remember that?
Yeah.
And that one time, I thought it was awesome because I was in the truck that went flying in the air, and we floated in the air for a while. So I was flying in a truck. I mean, how cool is that? Of course, we all got booted from the game, but... That was weird.
Yeah, I mean, it was pretty neat because I was in the same game with you. And you got stuck into the stairwell, and it's like your knees. It's like the stairs were up to your knees, and you couldn't get high enough to get out.
I kept jumping and jumping, and then I'd almost get out, and then I'd slide back down to the bottom of the
it's
stairs.
It's like a slide.
It was so frustrating.
Yeah, it was weird. So I went behind you and pushed you up. So that was kind of weird. But yeah, that truck one, that was a trip because... I mean, we were, you know, just messing around, so we actually somehow got the trucks over down to the beach and
flying it off the cliff. That was scary.
But then we were just, you know, ramming each other and stuff, and it was kind of funny. But then somehow your truck just got lifted up into the air, and you were seriously just driving around in the air. So it looked like your truck was flying. So that was kind of funny, at least from my point of view. You know, I was looking up and like thinking, what the heck? But I mean, there are glitches. But overall, I mean, the game's still fun.
Oh, yeah. Totally fun.
It's just crazy.
What about your power leveling?
Yeah, that was weird. I just really don't understand what happened. I mean, I was a level 3. I killed, what, like 3 or 4 guys after that? And then, boom, I was automatically a level 14.
Yeah. That was very unfortunate because I was still a level 3.
And I had that the option on where the enemies leveled with us. So... All of a sudden, you know, we were killing level 3s, and then boom, now there's level 13s and level 14s that
was getting murdered.
And even for me, though, because I was actually, even though I was a level 14, I had like level 3 weapons.
Yeah, that's right. That was so funny. You're like, I'm not doing any damage.
I know. What's up with that? At least my fists were pretty cool, but, you know, still, I don't understand what happened. So I guess next time we play, we'll have to start over again.
Yeah, the not being able to turn in quests. The other stuff you can kind of handle, but if you can't turn in quests, you can't level up as fast. So,
and that's strange, because when we were playing just us, there weren't glitches like that. We didn't run into anything too bad.
Very weird.
So, I don't know. We'll just,
like
I guess,
start
over.
A totally different game.
But yeah, for the rest of the week, I just played, apart from Dead Island, I played Halo Anniversary co-op with you, and that was pretty much it. I mean, honestly, you know what? This is what we should do. We should talk about some of the skulls.
Yeah.
So here's a disclaimer for anybody that's listening, and if you want complete spoiler-free listening here, just go ahead and go down to the description and skip to go to the retro segment, because we're not going to give away exactly the locations, but we're going to talk a little bit about some of the skulls and all that. So we'll pause for a few seconds here, give it a little few moments, and I guess we're good there, huh? All right, so the skulls. Pretty crazy.
Yeah. I had a hard time.
So most of them, I mean, I don't know. What do you think? They were, I mean, now you found two of the skulls. Or no, wait, you found the first skull.
On accident.
Just on accident. But that was really awesome. I mean, you just turned around and found it.
I was just jumping around and I'm like, hey, I found a skull.
No, it's kind of crazy. The other ones are pretty much, at least from what we found, pretty easy to find. But there's this one skull. And I mean, we're not going to tell exactly which level, so, you know, it's trying to keep it spoiler free. But that one was a trip. That one, I mean, grenade jumping? What's up with that?
I'm horrible at grenade jumping.
So when when we discovered where it was, and we were trying to get it, how many times do you think we kept trying to attempt that?
Oh my gosh, I don't know.
I'm thinking 30, 35 times or something like that. We spent
easily
an hour and a half, 2 hours trying to
Yeah. An hour and a half easily trying to get up there once we saw it.
I think the funniest thing is only one of us had an overshield, which, you know, for Halo trying to do that rocket or grenade jump.
I lost all of mine on the way there.
Yeah, so I was the one that kept trying to get up there. And,
but we got a checkpoint right before, which was nice.
Yeah, so every time
we were able to just kill ourselves and try again.
Exactly. So that was the good news. But, man, I mean, you even tried because you didn't have any frag grenades, right? So you were trying with plasma?
Yeah.
And no overshield?
No overshield. Yeah, instant death. But, you know, you never know. I might get lucky.
Your body flew up there a couple times.
Close to up there. It propelled upwards, but not over.
That's true. Once we kind of figured out, well, you know what, let's forget the grenades. And then there was that, we just went ahead, grabbed a rocket launcher and came back.
Yeah. It was cool that it was still open.
Yeah.
Because we moved on and it's like, oh yeah, rocket launcher. I wonder if we can go back. You're good at rocket launch jumping. I was so
Except
bad with that.
For the first couple of times when I was trying to run and just get, you know, like a running start, and then I totally whiffed it. So I jumped, shot, and it didn't even hit the ground and I just flew off the edge. So
yeah.
That's pretty bad. But yeah, I mean,
more than like five times.
Got him though.
Yeah. Got really lucky.
Actually, so
you're good at it. Me, not so much. I always blow myself up.
But how did, so actually, wait. So I got the skull first, right? So didn't you, that's right. You shot the ground right as I jumped at the peak of the jump, right? And that shot me up.
I shot the ground behind you to propel you forward.
That's right. That's right.
Yeah.
Now, we haven't found all the skulls yet, so I mean, I don't even know. I wonder if the other ones are kind of in crazy, super hard to find pieces too.
I wish it were like Halo 3. Then you can rocket jump yourself, get the skull and bring it back to me.
That's true. Because in this one, you actually have to pick it up yourself.
Yeah. In Halo 3, I wouldn't have to go and get it. All you need is one person that can reach it and you're good to go.
Bring it back. Can fetch it, fetch the skulls.
Unless that person's mean and leaves the skull up there.
Takes it and is.
You would do that to me, wouldn't you?
I probably would. All right. Well, you know what? Let's go ahead and end that spoiler section here. Not that there was a whole ton, but we'll end that there. So for this week, thinking retro segment, the Typing of the Dead for the Dreamcast.
I love typing games.
Now, Typing of the Dead, I'm already laughing because seriously, that game was a trip.
You know, when I first heard about it, I thought it was either a parody or a complete hoax.
Same here. Because honestly, you have to wonder. I mean, no, just all credit to the people who came up with this game, but this is freaking nuts. I mean, you got to really be thinking, you know, you got this crazy House of the Dead where you're, you know, you're shooting zombies with guns and stuff. And then you're gonna somehow just, you know what? I'm thinking we do the House of the Dead, guys. But let's take away the guns. Let's give them keyboards and make it a typing game. I mean, how do you come up with that?
I don't know.
Now, but I loved the fact that that the players had keyboards like strapped to them.
Yes.
That was so funny in the cutscenes or whatever.
Uh-huh. And the Dreamcast on their backs.
Yeah, the Dreamcast on their back.
That's so cool. The way they did it, it was pretty smart.
And seriously, you got to think about those words that we were typing.
Oh gosh.
Some of the phrases are like, what?
Was it like one of the boss battles is like optometrist? It's like, oh my gosh, how am I going to type this in time? Yeah. And some of the phrases.
Yeah. I mean, you're
wondering
reading it.
How random it is, or did they actually kind of purposely select some of these?
Oh, that's a good question. I don't know.
Yeah.
Because you're right. Some of those phrases are like, what the heck? And you're typing it because, you know, I mean, there's zombies coming at you.
Yeah.
So just for those people who don't know what Typing of the Dead is, you should look it up. Go to YouTube or someplace and you got to look at it. You got to see it because unless you have a Dreamcast, and if you have a Dreamcast, you seriously need to track down a copy of the game and either the Dreamcast keyboard or like a keyboard adapter. So if you can find this game, it's definitely worth trying out. But it's the House of the Dead game where you type words out that pop up on the screen and that's how you kill the zombies. So.
Yeah. And it's the full The House of the Dead 2, right?
Yeah.
I mean, it's the same game, the same horrible voice acting, everything. your character is replaced with the same character with a keyboard strapped to him.
Yeah.
And then, you know, a Dreamcast on his back.
Yep. And a giant battery, because it looks like a big battery on the top of the Dreamcast or something that looked like that.
Yeah. I thought it was a capacitor.
But I guess that's what's powering their system as they're they're going through the world typing.
Yeah.
And honestly, remember when they would like throw those projectiles or like, you know, toss a knife at you and you have to type those the little whatever letter it is?
Yeah.
While you're trying to kill zombies.
It gets hard.
Yeah,
that's actually a really hard game.
I tried normal. And that was seriously
those words come out fast.
Yeah.
And seriously.
Guys, and
I'm a touch typist and that is hard. It probably expects you to do it in like 100 words per minute or something.
I don't even know. But the game was funny. I think that it would be kind of neat. I don't know how they would kind of resurrect it, but I think it'd be awesome if they released, you know, either a port or maybe a Typing of the Dead 2. Or actually, they had that in Japan in the arcades. But something over here, you know, for future generations. Or just come up with just a brand new typing zombie game or something. I think that's kind of a neat concept.
Yeah. That'd be good for typing classes, like middle school, high school, where they're learning to type. Yeah. That'd be a motivator. Save the world by typing faster.
And you have to have bad voice acting, like you said. You got to have that bad voice.
Oh, yeah. Save me or help me or whatever. I mean, like not even an ounce of fear in the voice.
You need to get out of here. Yeah, good game.
Very good game.
Yes. So for those that do have the game, seriously, go dust off your Dreamcast, which it shouldn't have dust on it to begin with. But dust it off, bust out the game, and play it, because that thing is a lot of fun. That was so stupid and cheesy. I guess about as cheesy as a voice acting. I'm talking to myself now, aren't I? Yeah.
I have nothing to say.
Huh.
Sorry, I can't beat the amount of cheesiness you have.
Fair enough. Well, I guess we can wrap things up here. Well, we wanted to thank everyone who took out the time to listen to the show. Be on the lookout for next Sunday for show number 9. Special thanks to Ronald Jenkins for providing Disorganized Fun for the Infinite Live Show theme song.
Have a great week, everyone.